Orgies are ritualistic energy exchanges that provide the concentration of power needed for spellcasting. Witches and wizards crave energy, and in fact are very much addicted to it in all forms. And there's a special kind of energy derived from uniting with another. And so spellcasters do a tremendous amount of uniting. We know that a mystical bond exists between lovemakers. This bond is able to attract all sorts of good luck and success. An energy exchange celebration that is offered as a token to the gods will liberate your soul and expand your consciousness. You will be better able to absorb the raw energy of the cosmos and convert it quickly to your needs after you have participated in a glorious celebration of love. Enchanters need orgies. The orgy will help you generate the electric and magnetic impulses you'll need in order to cast spells. The best time for an orgy is during the dark of the moon, or when the moon is full, and again at the times of the equinoxes. These are periods when the earth is surrounded by wild vibrations, and when if the orgy is successful, you will be able to slip easily into the fifth dimension of fantasy. Gather what you need, and return stronger and ready to create your destiny. Traditional orgies have always consisted of either 9, 11, 13, or 22 guests. You are able to double the amount, triple it, increase it 7 times over. But you must never invite one more or one less. There's a reason for the strict discipline in witchcraft. And if you deviate from the rule, you could unleash powerful and unfortunate evil forces. So plan your orgy with care. Invite only a specified number of guests. To begin the orgy, all guests must stand in a circle. Each must light a red candle and dedicate the flame to the god Pluto. And then let the place be filled with laughter. And as the queen witch rings a pewter bell 3 times, psychic inspiration will direct the group activities. As an enchanter, you are committed to each spell cast. You can't turn back.